A very warm welcome to this presentation. This is a presentation with crypto insights and tips and tricks. My name is Jan-Robert Schut of Crypto Academy, and Crypto Academy is here the symbolic bridge from the normal world to the crypto world, and we are aiming to do that and to help you. First, a disclaimer: everything what I'm saying and presenting, it's just for educational purposes. It is not a trading advice. That being said, we would like to give you a short overview of the crypto market with some crypto insights. My name is Jan-Rob Schut and I'm CEO and co-founder of Crypto Academy. That is one of the largest crypto communities in the Netherlands. I founded Crypto Academy back in 2017. And before that, I had several years. I've got now more than 25 years trading experience in options and stocks and futures. And from 2017, we are helping private investors to make money in the crypto market because we know how difficult it is. Apart from being a crypto trader, I'm also a crypto consultant and also a keynote speaker. Let's say I'm a kind of traveling circus around the world. And returned from Dubai and also from Kiev. And in Dubai, I got this reward for speaking, and actually, I also finished a book in Dutch, actually, and I hope to translate it soon in English. This is a book about crypto trading for an ambitious beginner. As I said, I am also traveling around the world. Soon I will be on the Blockchain Fest 2021 in December in Cyprus, and I'm looking forward to meet the team over there. And the thing is that you have to start, and somebody who did not start yet in the crypto market, I would just say, take the first step. The destination to the big bucks is beginning with one step. And I hope that I can help you with this, to take this step. First, you have to know about the crypto market. And the crypto market, you have to put in perspective. And that means that there are more than 14,000 cryptos already available in the market. And to find a good coin is like to find a needle in a haystack. It's a hell of a job, of course, but one of the ports I'm always considering, that is CoinMarketCap. Also, another one is CoinGecko, but CoinMarketCap is more precise, and also I like this more. There is a kind of ranking from the big top 10. That is from Bitcoin number one, Ethereum number two, XRP, etc., and Solana. And the other way to show the crypto market in perspective is via coin360.com. And there you see a very nice overview. And there you see Bitcoin is now around 43.5 Bitcoin dominance, the market dominance. That means that almost half of the crypto market is still dominated by Bitcoin. You can also see that Ethereum takes a big share of the pie, and Ethereum has a market dominance of more or less 20%. So Bitcoin and Ethereum is already almost 2/3 of the market. That means that if you don't have these two coins in portfolio and the market is going higher with Bitcoin and Ethereum in the lead, you miss many opportunities. Nevertheless, there are more coins, of course, than Bitcoin and Ethereum. There you can see also the little fields. When the market is green, when the market is rising, you can see a very nice green area, but when the market is dropping from a coin, the price dropping there, you see the red. And the bigger the piece is, the bigger the market dominance is. There is so much information outside in the world about crypto. And the thing is that what I'm doing with the crypto aggregator, that is CryptoPanic, I'm using this CryptoPanic to gather all the information all the information about the crypto market, not to seek for the next coin, but to know what is happening in the market. It's very important, and that is in one place. This is a chart of the total market cap. Here you can see that the total market cap is more or less 2.8 trillion, and this is a sheet of 1 week ago, and we almost touched the 3 trillion, that means $3,000 billion market cap. This is including BTC. But as you can see, in 2021, at the start was 1 trillion, now almost 3. So the market threefolded in market cap. But what is also very promising is that, encouraging as well, is that the total market cap, excluding BTC, is also rising. Also, it broke above the high of April, May. So that means that the market is strong in this sense. This is very important to understand the Bitcoin dominance where I was talking about before. The market dominance of Bitcoin was in the beginning of the year around 70%, and it dropped all to the low of 43 or 40 even. And that means that when the market dominance of Bitcoin is diminishing, when it's dropping, that means that the altcoins are taking over. And it's very important to understand, because when the dominance of the Bitcoin is dropping and altcoin markets is higher, that means that there are many opportunities with to make return in the altcoin market. Also, the Ethereum dominance that is here is also picking up. But the peculiar thing is that Ethereum dominance, you can see, it's around 20%. And it has been higher in back in 2018, 19, it was even 32%. But I think that Ethereum will perform better sooner. I will explain later why. My take on the market with Bitcoin. Bitcoin at the end of Q1, first quarter of 2022, in March, my aim is quite conservative, 100,000. And that is because many big institutions are coming into the market, and more, and also the market, the crypto market, is getting more mainstream, and Bitcoin is being considered also as digital gold. It is more as a store of value, and because it's number one, it will stay number one, one for the longer term as well. That's why Bitcoin has to be a cornerstone in your portfolio. Other thing is that the stock to flow model, I will explain a little bit how it works. The stock to flow model, the S2F model, is also used in the commodity market. And that means that with the kind of scarcity and predictions, you can guess more or less where the price will go. Anyway, here is a chart plotted from 2010 towards 2026, starting at even 1 cent, mind you. And the target is here at 2026, around $1 million. And as you see the S2F line, this is a blue line, that is going up, and you are here at 2021. We are now more or less at 100,000. And because I'm quite conservative, I think also this target will be in the first quarter of 2022. But as you can see, the price actually is rising, it's plotted there, and the chart is more or less, the chart is here around 60, 70,000, as you can see. Also, the market sometimes dropping like crazy. Of course, the crypto market is very volatile. That is the art of the nature, that is the nature of the beast, and you have to tighten your seatbelt as well when the market is dropping. Also this year, we had a huge drop from 60,000 to 30,000 from May, June towards July. And then after that, the market picked up again, and now we are trading around 64,000. Ethereum is now trading around 4,700 more or less, and my target is 6,000. In Q1 2022. And why? Because I think first Ethereum has a far better use case than Bitcoin, because on the Ethereum platform there are smart contracts running, also DeFi protocols, NFT protocols, and these kind of things. So Ethereum has much more to offer, I think, and it's more than 50% increase in the near term. I have this take on the market. And the thing is that here the chart is around 4,500. And the thing is, why do I think it's going to 6,000? It's because of the charting analysis, is that we have found a very big support area around 2,000 in the beginning of May, June, July, until the peak rounded off to 4,000. So this trading range 2,000, it has reached and also broke out to the upside again. So that means that this range of 2,000, you can project it on top of the 4,000. That means 4 plus 2 is 6. So that's why my 6,000 target is on the table. I would like to give you some trading tips and strategies, and that is you have two possibilities. You can buy and hold, of course, buy and hodl. That means you buy one bunch of Bitcoin and Ethereum for longer term and you keep it for your whole life. That is not my my strategy. I prefer to take some chips off the table when I'm in the profit one time. And the thing is that also when you buy Bitcoin, you enter the market, it's better, in my opinion, to spread the investment. So if you want to invest, for instance, $10,000 in 5 coins, then it's far better, I think, to buy 5 coins for $2,000 and also spread spread over in several months. So when you, for instance, in 10 months, you want to construct this portfolio of 10,000, then 2,000 divided by 10 is 200. So every month you're going to buy for 5 coins for 200. And then after 10 months, you have a very nice portfolio constructed. That means that when you invest the first month 1,000 divided over 5 coins, that means that the next month, no matter how high or how low the market is, just buy these 5 coins again. And that means that if the market is higher, you buy less coins for the same price and for the same amount. And when the market is dropping, the market is lower, then you can obtain more coins. And don't fool yourself by saying, okay, if the market is rising, I will not buy it anymore because it's too high. And because there is emotional trading also when the market is dropping, don't be panicking, and also don't have fear if the market is at the bottom that you are afraid to buy again because you think the market will fall further. No, because you have the strategy DCA, every month you buy 4,000 euros these 5 coins. So this is one part, because you buy the coins, but you have also to exit one time. And the thing is that what I'm also doing, for instance, when I buy in first month one basket of the 5 coins, for instance, 6 months later or 1 year later, you sell the first bunch, the first part which you bought in month one, because when the market is high, you take some profits out of the market, also the investment. You can also reinvest in other coins again. So always take some profits one time. But very important, diversify amongst diverse coins. And the other thing is that the swing trading portfolio is more for the shorter term, for several weeks or months, or even years maybe. In that case, I buy for 100 euros or $100 coins, let's say 10 coins in one time. Then I have a basket of $1,000 invested. And the trick is when the market is, for instance, 50 or 60% higher, and you take profit for the half of the position, and let the rest run. For instance, I've also Loopring. I reduced the investment from 250 euros all the way down to 30, and I'm 700% into the plus. Of course, I have also losses. I have also a coin with a loss of, for instance, 40, 50% lower or 25%. That is also recommendable for the swing trading portfolio to have a stop loss in place, not for the dollar cost averaging strategy because it is a different strategy, but for the swing trading portfolio, yes. But very important again, let the profits run. Take some chips off the table, of course, but always leave some chips on the table to let it grow. And diversify is very important. But now, how to find the needle in a haystack, the big haystack of 14,000 coins. On TradingView, you can create an account free, and you can create watch lists. What I did for Binance coins, I did coins in a watch list of Binance, for instance, more than 200 I added here. I have also a list of DeFi coins. It's a category. And also, for instance, smart contracts platform coins. I already put it in place, and my members, our members, they get these watch lists for free. And now the thing is, okay, now you know which coins there are. Now the question is when to buy, when to sell. There we have a very nice indicator. The only thing what you have to do, you have to take a look at if the price is rising and you get a buy signal here, for instance, when the background is green, that means that you have to buy this coin, or you can buy this coin, and you have to stay as long as possible in the market. Here's a Lubring, as I told, I bought it more or less, I think even for 60 cents, 50 cents, and now it already tripled, maybe quadrupled. But also on the way up, I have to admit that I took some chips off the table, because I have a strategy after 50% rise, I take half the position out. But the problem, the main important thing is that you have a strategy, and this is very nice strategy, don't have doubt. And when the market is dropping, it's red, just go out. And when the arrow is green again, just buy. As you can see, it's not always that you buy at the bottom and also you sell at the top. No, but it's very important that if you are in a market, buying this coin, I also already have in portfolio, it says a buy arrow at 460, now it's trading around 610. More or less almost 50% higher. And that is very good that you see that as long as you are in the position, and then ride the wave. With the Extend Crypto portfolio, I'm aiming to make money with the 10K until 100K, hence the 10X or Extend. That means that with the strategy, we already have some nice coins in portfolio. Some are in the plus, some in the minus. But Lubring, for instance, now here is 280% higher. And I reduced actually the investment from 250 all the way down to 31. And the profit is $87 or euros. And so this is, you can also take this subscription, of course, for 1,000 euros for 1 year, for 12 months. So on average, $83 or euros per month invested as a subscription, but you get very nice, decent results. And here it says the total result is 3,700. Now it's already 4,600. But now the thing is that I have here a nice Excel sheet. What I need is, for instance, my portfolio aggregated in one app. And I have CryptoWatch, for instance. This is a very important one. And here it says I got 42 assets. I've got more because not all the exchanges are connected. And the thing is that here I've got a big bunch of fee chains, for instance, BNB, Shiba, Lubring. And here there's a kind of market map. You can take a look how the performance is. But the other thing is that also very nice coin stats I like very much, because here you can, I have here added Binance, a Deribit, a Ledger wallet. I've also Ledger. And that is this cold storage, because some coins I've got here on cold storage. Nano Ledger X is very good. I also connected with Algorand, Bitcoin Cash. And as you can see, the Binance is a quite big bunch. Binance Coin and Polkadot. And here you can also see the profits of the current holdings, P&L. 24%, 180%, 150% higher. Almost 400% of Lubring, 800% of Sealer Network. Is now worth $481. So, and these were investments for only $100 or $200. And you can see that you don't need very much money to start trading. But the thing is that you can see here's now a total balance of $20,000. And it's only a part of the other exchanges because the point is with CoinStats and Crypto Watch, is that you cannot add all the exchanges. Anyway, this is just a start. If you're interested actually in a free smart contract platform coin, I have written this report in English, and I'm dealing also about crypto trading. I have the first introduction in English, translated a couple of pages from Dutch into English. It's also in this container. Also, I added three coins. It's Cardano, Polkadot, and VeChain. These coins are still one of my favorites. So if you're interested, go to the webpage with the QR code. But a very important tip and trick, finally, there you see you have to diversify and also avoid too much leverage, because you can see what happens when you take too much leverage. Then you get very big pain. you get hurt, like this little kid here, and this is a problem many traders are doing. And Crypto Academy, we are aiming to help you further in the crypto market, to make this all a little bit bigger and to let you score hole-in-ones. And this is also a very nice one. This is Harold, one of our members. He says, crypto trading, who said crypto was very stressful? I'm 25 and I'm feeling great. So I would like to thank you for your attention, of course. This is my QR code for my information. This is my WhatsApp number. And also, if you would like to take a look for more information, go to cryptoacademy.nl. And I'm happy to help you further. And thank you very much for your attention. And I hope that you found this presentation very valuable. And if you like the video, feel free to click like or to subscribe on my YouTube channel. Also below that, you'll find a link with the Crypto Extend Challenge if you would like to add it and to follow that. Or if you want to buy the book in Dutch for crypto trading for mission beginners, you can also find the link in the link below. Thank you very much for your attention and good luck with crypto trading.